Torrey and Dan, WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.
I'm not ignoring
I challenge the speaker for the ignorance
if not,
of the opposition.
The clerk will take the call.
Nope, it doesn't work that way.
Madam
Speaker, it does not work that way.
Madam Speaker, explain my vote.
I challenge the speaker.
Madam Speaker.
I challenge the role of the speaker. It takes first precedence. Madam Speaker, you know I love you, but you have to sit down.
I am not sitting down.
Wow, absolute chaos on the floor of the Maryland House of Delegates. And I think it's really important for folks, like people need to go and watch what actually happened, right? Because there's a lot more that's going on than what some are putting out there. Again, you know, it's... I don't know. It makes everybody a little uncomfortable, don't you think, Dan, when people are, you know, fighting?
Yelling at each other. Nobody likes to see people yelling at each other, especially in a professional setting.
And if you know a little bit of background, right, as I understand, Delegate Kipke and Speaker Jones, they have a long history. There's a friendship that's there. And so, but again, politics is politics. And joining us now to give us some more insight is the delegate himself, Delegate Nick Kipke. He's out of Anne Arundel County, District 31 Delegate. And Delegate Kipke, thanks for joining us on the program. Obviously, things were quite intense. Can you give our audience a little bit of insight as to what was going on that led to this rather tense exchange between you and Speaker Jones?
I was really flabbergasted. I mean, I've been elected for 17 years, and I've seen the speaker challenged in the past. And the way that works is a rule in our rule book where you can challenge the ruling or the motion, you know, of the speaker and what happens in that process. And I've done it in the past. I was a little shocked at the way things were going yesterday, which is why I felt like something needed to be done. But what happens is you stand and you challenge what the speaker did. And as long as two other members stand with you, the speaker has to get down from the rostrum, get in a seat of a regular member of the general of the House of Delegates, and the speaker pro tem goes to the rostrum and just basically asks the question. We vote. Do you support the speaker or not? And, you know, hey, look, I was emotional. I regret, you know, I was a little out of my, you know, typical personality. But I was flabbergasted and upset. And it spilled over from we had a tremendous bill pass the legislature that dramatically restricts the lawful use and carry of firearms in this state. It's unconstitutional, and it was given a very short debate. There were amendments we were not allowed to offer, and you know, a lot of us have a lot of, you know, we were very upset about that. It was pushed through on sine die, and in a hurried way. And then here at the very end of session, you know, some bills that I think are really offensive. That in fact, you know. There is the bill that passed is like a it makes it harder for drug traffickers to be caught, essentially. And here it pops up at 5 or 6 or 7 minutes before sine die, and we weren't allowed to debate it.
Okay, you know, Delegate, why do you think that Speaker Jones decided that she didn't want you to speak? Do you think that it was because she was afraid that you were going to make salient points and that people were going to change their minds? Or was it just because you're Republicans and she doesn't want to have anything to do with that?
I can't speak for why the speaker was doing what she was doing, but I will always stand up and listen. I mean this sincerely. I will do my best to be more respectful about it in the future. It's not normally the way. I was just flabbergasted. And quite frankly, you know, we need to stand up. Republicans throughout the country, especially in Maryland, feel very, you know, oppressed about the way that things are going in our government. And at least we can be a voice for them. You know, we represent millions of people, and we're their voice in the legislature, even if we're going to lose. You know, we have a right to speak, and I felt like our right to speak was being muted yesterday.
We're speaking with Delegate Nick Kipke, District 31 out of Anne Arundel County. And I suppose, so you did call and you did, you know, speak to the speaker. What was that conversation like, and what did you guys, you know, have to say?
It's a little bizarre because, you know, the thing has been produced really, you know, by the media, obviously, because it's such an unusual event into this grand big deal, and it is. But you know, the speaker and I have a long-term, nearly two-decade relationship, and you know, I believe she's fond of me. I'm fond of her. We have a warm relationship, and you know, I apologized to her for the tone that I used. You know, I should have been more respectful about it. But in the heat of the moment, I was upset. And, nevertheless, you know, I want to teach my kids to be respectful. I need to be respectful too. But she was gracious. She accepted the apology. And, you know, at some later point, I do want to talk to her about, you know, bills of great magnitude, you know, bills that relate to drug traffickers or, you know, taking away people's Second Amendment rights. I just think that they should be allowed. Those are big bills. They should be allowed the opportunity for all voices to be heard. And so I'd like to see bills like that, if they're going to pass, be moved earlier so that we can have the full and robust debate that they deserve.
Did it seem to you, Delegate, as though the Democrats in Annapolis this session were more interested in promoting a national Democratic Party agenda than they were an agenda for the state of Maryland and specifically for the problems that are currently facing Baltimore City? Did you get that sense?
I am disappointed that we didn't do more to address some of like the nitty-gritty issues that we have in our state. And so, yes, I do believe that some of the bills that passed that, you know, are I don't know, more partisan in nature. And certainly there were plenty of bills that, you know, the Republicans had to oppose, many of them unanimously. I feel like we should be focused more on the nitty gritty, the things that that need to be addressed in our state. And it may be a reaction. You know, we went with 8 years with a Republican governor. And we have three levels of government now controlled, the House, Senate, and the governor's office. So maybe that was the reaction that, there's a governor there that's going to be in alignment on them politically.
Are there any bright spots from the legislative session that you can think of? With bipartisan support or something that you can point to say, despite how bad things were, we at least got this done.
We worked together to pass a bill. You know, there's a loophole in Maryland's child pornography laws. They basically haven't kept up with technology, and consuming child pornography, which is vile and disgusting, consuming that through a streaming service technically was not against the law.
Oh, really?
And so, obviously that needed to be fixed. It wasn't easy to fix it, but in the end, everybody came together and the bill passed in a bipartisan way.
All right, Delegate Kipke, thanks so much for your time and thanks for the work that you and your colleagues are doing on the floor. And glad things were smoothed over and best of luck on that follow-up call, because we're intrigued to know how there will be a more balanced representation from the minority party. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Have a great day.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
All right. That was Delegate Nip Kipke out of District 31, Anne Arundel County. And sounds like things are smoothed over for now, but we'll see. We'll see how things turn out next year.